Would you like to raise your credit score just by using your credit cards? Let's get into three hacks you can use to dramatically increase your credit score, including when you should pay your credit card bill, how many credit cards you should have, and how to become a FICO credit score high achiever so you can get approved for any card that you want. Also, please do yourself a favor and check out the link in the description. Slick Deals has some excellent articles on everything credit card related. So one of the most powerful ways to use your credit cards to raise your credit score is determined by how you handle payments. The timing and the size of your payments will significantly impact your credit score in two ways, and that's your payment history and credit utilization rate, which together make up 65% of your credit score. The best strategy that I've come across that helps you achieve your best personal score is called AZO, or all zero except for one. With this method, you would pay off all of your credit card statement balances except for one before your billing cycle closing date, and you will only pay off 90% of the statement balance of the final card by its closing date. Then you pay off the remaining 10% by the final bill's due date. So for an example, if you had three cards with a $1,000 statement balance on them, then you pay off $2,900 before the billing cycle date and the remaining $100 before the final card's due date. Paying close attention to your bills in this way all but guarantees your payments will be on time. You can even set up auto pay as a backup so you have an extra safeguard. Also, paying the vast majority of your balance before the billing cycle date ensures that only a very small balance gets reported to the credit agencies. It's been shown that having below a 10% utilization rate will give you your best possible FICO score with each credit bureau. Based on data from the FICO scoring company itself, high achievers have a credit utilization below 7% on average. The reason why paying the entire balance from the start is not recommended is because it also has been proven that a zero balance will incur a small penalty within the FICO scoring model. How you decide to make payments on your credit cards gives you the most control over your credit score since it's recalculated monthly and it's a snapshot in time of your current performance. The next hack is using balance transfers to your advantage. Balance transfers can help you in two ways. First, if you have outstanding credit card debt and you're currently paying interest, then you can sign up for a credit card that offers a 0% balance transfer promotional rate. Usually they last for 12 to 15 months. That allows you to transfer the debt to the new card and free up the money you were paying towards interest and gives you the ability to pay down the principal amount faster. As that debt load gets paid down, it improves your credit utilization rate and your credit score. The second way balance transfers help you is when signing up for a new credit card, you're dramatically increasing your overall available credit limit. That immediately improves your credit utilization rate and score the moment that the new account gets reported to the credit agencies, and that's even before you make any payments. And here's a bonus third benefit. When you open a card and use additional features of that card when signing up, it puts you in great position for future credit limit increases because the bank sees that you're receptive to their add-on credit card products. I think of those extra offers like upsells for the bank. And in this situation, you can use it to your advantage since you're actually getting real value from it. Some credit cards will even offer promotional balance transfer rates to existing customers, so you can still use this method to assist you in speeding up your debt repayment timeline without signing up for a completely new card and triggering a hard credit pull. For more information about specific credit cards, definitely check out the link in the description. They have some great information over there. So there's an old saying, if you can't measure it, you can't improve it. You want to be able to accurately see where you can make improvements to address issues on your credit report. Solving just a few critical problems could easily add 50 to 100 points to your score. That's why it's important to always know your current credit score, but it's also critical that you're looking at the correct credit score. You want to track the scoring model that all the credit card issuers use to evaluate your credit worthiness. Banks will use the FICO 8 bank card scoring model for credit cards. It was released over 10 years ago, and it doesn't look like that's changing anytime soon, despite what the headlines are telling you. Historically, it used to cost money to access your FICO credit scores, but now some of the large banks will provide it to you for free. It's important to identify whether the bank is showing you your FICO score or your Vantage score. So many people get this mixed up. The FICO score is what you really need to measure your performance and guide your decisions. When you add one of these bank supply scores, you'll see a description along with a color code telling you how well you're doing in that category. You'll want to improve anything that's in red or yellow. Typically, the fastest way to increase your score will be reducing your credit utilization or slowing up the number of credit card inquiries that show up on your report by not applying for a new card for 6 months to a year. The added benefit of keeping a close eye on your score is being well informed about your qualifications before applying for new credit cards. Some higher tier cards require excellent credit scores along with very few inquiries within the last 6 months to a year before they'll even approve you. This will help you completely avoid any unnecessary denials that leave you both without the new card you really wanted and a slightly damaged credit score because of the hard pull that was triggered. Based on FICO data, 70% of the highest achievers have not applied for a credit card in the past year, and the average time since their last hard inquiry was 2.5 years ago. Yes, that's the average, and I know that's gonna seem mighty long for some of you. And if you're getting value from this video, please hit the like button. Let's go through each part of your FICO score and talk about some common problems and solutions. Payment history makes up 35% of your score, and 30 to 60 day late payments will absolutely devastate your credit score. Earlier, I mentioned the all zero except one payment method, which is great, but you can try a few others, like paying off every transaction the moment it posts to your account, or paying your credit card balance every time you get paid, whether that's weekly or bi-weekly. To become a high achiever in this category, you must have zero late payments. Credit utilization rate makes up 30% of your score. We already established that keeping this rate in the single digits will give you your best outcome. But I just want to add that high achievers only let 3 accounts report any balance whatsoever to the credit agencies. That's why the AZO method works so well, because that method only allows you to let 1 balance report, which is even better. Next, length of credit history makes up 50% of your score. This can be an issue for younger people that just don't have any lengthy history of using credit cards. There's really no meaningful way to improve this aspect of your credit score beyond having patience. But I will say that you shouldn't let this part of your score discourage you from signing up for and canceling credit cards. A new credit card could offer you significant value, so signing up would still be overwhelmingly advantageous, or an old card could charge you an expensive annual fee, so canceling would definitely be the right move, since cards canceled in good standing will remain on your report for 10 years and you'll likely see little to no drop in your score. Next is credit inquiries, or amount of new credit, which accounts for 10% of your score. You want to keep your amount of hard pulls as low as possible. You can do this by keeping new credit card applications to a minimum or being very careful when manually requesting credit limit increases, since some credit card issuers will hard pull your report for doing so. On the other hand, automatic limit increases will never damage your score. Next is credit mix, which is worth 10% of your score. This section is all about how many installment and revolving accounts you have. Some people can be timid about applying for new lines of credit, but generally, the more you have, the better. In fact, high achievers on average have 5 installment loans and 6 bank-issued credit cards. So if you're in a good position, you might want to consider adding a valuable card to your collection. Most likely, it will help raise your score. If you want more information like this, then check out Slick Deals in the description. They have all the up-to-date information about credit cards. Also, check out this video next because YouTube thinks you'll love it. Thank you for watching, and you have a good one.